repairing or lengthening an instrument cable, making a proper wire splice that is durable and weatherproof is easy when you follow these instructions and use an Apogee Instruments wire splice kit. Before you begin, please gather these supplies: wire cutters, wire strippers, a heat gun, a soldering iron, and solder, and an Apogee wire splice kit, which includes solder sleeves and polyolefin adhesive lined heat shrink. In the following demonstration, we'll be using 26 gauge 2 conductor shielded cable. For other kinds of wire, the process is the same, but you will need an additional solder sleeve for each conductor. Step 1. Strip the outer cable insulation 5/8 of an inch, while stripping and tinning the individual wires 1/4 of an inch. Note that tinning the individual lead wires helps to eliminate cold solder joints by cleaning the individual strands and allowing solder to flow more freely. Step 2. Slide the solder sleeves onto the wires, making sure the tinned ends are inside the solder rings. Step 3. Slide the outer heat shrink onto one of the cables to the side of the splice. Be sure to slide it far enough onto the cable away from the joint so the heat gun will not heat it up before you're finished with the next steps. Step 4. Slide the cable that is to be spliced into the other end of the solder sleeve, making sure the tinned ends are inside the solder rings. Verify that the wires match up, for example, red to red, black to black, and so on. Step 5. Heat the solder sleeves using a heat gun until the solder flows. Remove the heat and be careful not to pull on the cable on individual wires until the solder is set. For step 6, slide the polyolefin adhesive lined heat shrink over the junction of the wires. This will seal the splice from the elements, allow an extra 1 inch of coverage by the heat shrink on the outer jacket of cable to ensure a good seal. Use the heat gun and notice that the heat shrink forming tightly to the cable and splice. The adhesive lined heat shrink will have a glossy look once the glue is flowed. Be careful not to overheat the heat shrink. If overheated, it will start to warp and eventually melt away. Allow all the parts to cool before moving. Please note that the heat shrink will be flexible when warm, but will hold an angle if left bent while it's cooling. There may be a small amount of adhesive coming from the heat shrink ends. This is normal. When done properly, a cable splice can be just as weatherproof as the jacket itself. In fact, we use Adem brand heat shrink and have conducted tests showing that it's at least as impermeable to water ingress as the cable Santoprene jacket. Unless otherwise noted, adhesive-lined heat shrink has a difficult time adhering to Teflon cable, also known as PTFE.